Now let's move on to the market. We have the Nigerian Stock Exchange All Share Index closing down 2.1% to 34,098. Market capitalization down to 10.91 trillion naira. We've seen gains in Nestle, Nigerian Breweries, BOC Gas, Unilever. Losses today in Dangote Cement, FBN Holdings, Diamond Bank. Now joining me to discuss the activities in the equities market is Adebayo Adejumo. Now he's, as I said, a portfolio manager at Investment One. Adebayo, it's definitely good to have you on the show today.
Thank you. Good afternoon.
Let's start by focusing on Diamond Bank's full year results, which of course came out today. We have a revenue up 35%. We have profit after tax up as well, which is an improvement from the loss that the bank had last year. It would be good to start, first of all, by getting your general impression of the numbers.
Well, the result was actually released to the market this afternoon. Looking at the numbers, it was quite impressive when you compare to what the bank did last year. The profit before tax up to 27 billion, while profit after tax posted was 22 billion. But basically, invested public are actually looking at corporate actions. Mm. Apart from the numbers being fantastic, what's the reward? What's the reward in financial terms? So because no dividend was declared, no bonus was actually declared, investing public reacted to it negatively. Mm. The stocks moved from 7 naira down to 630 kobo at the close of market today. Well, it's not only Diamond. The investors actually look at other banks too.
Just to cut in there, I think it's definitely interesting that despite good results we're getting from companies, that you know the market seems to be reacting more to dividend payments. Mm-hmm. I mean, we saw a similar thing in the case of Okomo, I believe, last week, where you know their results were not that great, but then of course because of the 7 naira per share and one for one bonus, we saw that stock continue to rally. So is it that investors are more focused on dividend payments and maybe even less on the earnings per share of the company?
Yeah, basically. And you should not also forget that stocks like Diamond 3-4 months down the line was trading around 4 naira, 5 naira, and investors took position in these stocks because they felt they would get something at the end of the day. Mm. And the stock capital appreciation, they moved from 4 naira to 7 naira, say, in April. So, but looking at the result, like I said, result fantastic, but no dividend. So, basically, what investors are looking at is, okay, let's take profit. So basically, the only reward they have is capital appreciation. For those who have bought at say 4 naira, 50 kobo, 5 naira in January or December last year, so it's the only capital appreciation there. But basically, like I mentioned, they also look at other stocks. It's not only Diamond; they look at UBA, even First Bank, UBA, First Bank, Sky Bank. Those ones have not released their results. UBA down again from 8 naira. To 7 naira 20 kobo.
Is that on the back of the results that we're seeing from Diamond, or because investors are tired of waiting for UBA to release their results?
Because basically I think it's the result posted
Diamond.
By Diamond, and don't also forget the Q1 result released by Access.
Yes.
PBT dropped by 26%. Mm. So that also have negative impacts on the market overall.
Now let's talk about these plans to raise $750 million. Now that's of course a very large amount. Some might get the impression that bank, Diamond, might be in trouble if they're going to raise such an amount, and perhaps this is why the market reacted negatively too. What's your view?
Well, my view is raising funds does not necessarily mean that the bank is in trouble.
Of course.
Basically, the banks might want to expand. So, but the major problem that I see, the only concern I see, is the timing. Investors are expecting you to pay dividend and releasing result and pay dividend, and at the same time, you're also proposing to raise capital. But by and large, I don't think there is any problem in terms of raising capital. I don't think the bank is in trouble. Mm-hmm. The reason why the shares suffered today is because share price suffered today is because no dividend declared, no corporate action, no bonus declared, and while the result was released.
What are your quarter one expectations for the rest of the banks? Of course, as you mentioned, Access, that was pretty disappointing. What do you think is going to happen with the rest?
Well, it's a hard call, really. But that will actually dictate the direction of the market going forward in Q2. We've seen assets result dropped by 26, and that also impacted on the reaction in the market today. Investors are not sure of what other banks would release in Q1, so that's why you see that. Okay, for some of them that have bought, say, UB at 5 naira, why am I holding? Let me sell now and let them release the 2012 financials and let them release Q1 before I take a position again. Mm. So what would detect the direction of the market going forward, particularly in Q2, is the Q1 result of those banks.
But I mean, speaking about Q2, I mean, of course, we also know that CBN has its new tariff for, COT, and of course, the removal of ATM charges. That's obviously going to have quite an effect on banking earnings going forward. Do you think that, you know, maybe the market is reacting to that news as well? I mean, earlier, I believe I mentioned 1.8 trillion naira that was announced by Access Bank per quarter being the amount that they feel that they could be losing as a result of this new rule from the central bank.
Yes, it's also one of the reasons why you say selling pressure, particularly in those banks. And also, if you also look at the interest rate environment now, yield on government security is quite low. Mm. So that will also have negative impact on the results of those banks, particularly in Q1 and Q2. And that's why I see investors are not sure of the directions. So, like I said, what would dictate the market in Q2 will be based on the numbers releasing, their numbers in Q1.
And of course, we'll continue to look forward to getting those numbers, and hopefully we can have you on the show again to talk more about that. Right. But that's let's leave it there. Of course, I've been speaking to Adebayo Adejumo. He's a portfolio manager at Investment.